I'm seeing online that it is the 13-year anniversary of the release of Nicki Minaj's Your Love. And I'm incredibly proud of that song. I think that song's amazing. It was one of my first number one records. Super, super dope record. Obviously, Nicki Minaj is a fantastic artist. But that song almost didn't happen. The story of that song really kind of starts with this idea that Pop Wanzel, who I was working with at the time, a producer, amazing producer, and still I consider him a brother, had the idea to take the 8-bar loop from the beginning of Annie Lennox's No More I Love You and literally just put a kick clap to it. And they were, by they, I mean Nicki and Pop, were having like an email correspondence or whatever. And Pop mistakenly happened to add that production into the attachment section of the email. And so naturally, Nicki came back. And this was early. This was like when Nicki was still doing her like mixtape days and she was getting on a couple of features and et cetera. But this is prior to her releasing any albums or any singles for that matter. And so she hit Pop back and was like, yeah, I want to jump on this. Let me do it. So she ended up writing the hook for Your Love and then writing verses over it, and was like, yeah, this is dope. Long story short, it kind of got lost in the sauce. Didn't hear from it for a while. She obviously moved on to record the stuff. You know, artists record a million things all the time, a million different ideas. But somehow, lo and behold, and I promise it wasn't me, I have no idea how it happened, but the song leaked. The song came out, and it was such a, I guess for that period, a viral hit, that even without her label being aware of what was going on, the song actually charted, like, as a leak, which is unheard of. Well, today it's not so unheard of, but back then that was a big issue. And so naturally the conversation came about, well, oh my God, this song is starting to work. We should really do something about putting this record out officially. So naturally when that happens, like, labels have to go get permission from, like, when you use a sample in a record, you got to go get permission from the original creator of that sample. So they did, and they went to Annie Lennox and they said, hey, you know, Nicki Minaj has this record that's working, and it's a sample of one of your songs, and we'd like permission to use the master recording and to use the writing. And she said no. Now, the interesting thing about that is there's a lot of reasons why people told me that she said no. I've never heard from her directly why she decided she didn't want to clear that sample, so I'm not going to speculate on that. But the point is, she decided she didn't want that particular recording to be associated with Nicki Minaj. And okay, fine. But then we found out something really interesting. As it relates, I'm going to give you a quick lesson. Songs have two sides, the recording and the song. Every song has two sides, the recording and the song. The recording itself, you can write a song and then have 15 people record different versions of it. Each one of those versions end up being a master recording of a song that was written. But there's only one song in this situation. For instance, you can think of, I don't know, With a Little Help from My Friends by the Beatles. But then there's also the version by Joe Cocker. Yesterday, again, by the Beatles. But then there's another version by Boyz II Men. The version by Boyz II Men is its own master. Boyz II Men owns that master, but they do not own the writing. Paul McCartney and the Beatles own the writing to Yesterday. So every song has two sides, the recording and the writing, okay, or the publishing side. Typically, the producers own the master recording side. The producers and the record label jointly own it. And then the writers own the writing side of it. We found out that Annie Lennox didn't write this song. We found out that if we were able to recreate the sample, that we would actually be able to use it, because Annie Lennox wasn't going to be able to tell us that we couldn't, since she didn't own the writing. All we had to do was go to the songwriters of that record. And so we found out that the writers of the song, David Freeman, Joseph Hughes, were more than okay with allowing us to use this song for Nicki Minaj's record, For Your Love. But then the challenge came down to us having to recreate the intro to that song. Now I'm going to play you the original version of that, which in and of itself was hard to make, but sounds simple enough. Okay. So this is the original version. I know this so well because, oh my God. So when this track was originally done, it was literally just that plus a kick clap. That's all it was. It was really simple production to do. Recreating this was a monumental task First of all, go into the whole process of learning how the record was put together, finding out what synthesized instruments they used, finding out exactly the tempo, exactly the key, exactly the chords, figuring out all those concepts. And so after doing that, and after about a 2-day period, this was the remake of that same section. Now, this is just the music, which in and of itself was hard to make, but sounds simple enough. Okay. Then, of course, we had to add the vocal because that's one of the most important parts of that sample. Now, I know that when they recorded this song, Annie and the original writers and the producer for this record all got together on the mic to sing that. Right? They all got together. It wasn't just Annie singing it. So in order to layer it correctly, in order to make it sound as close to the original as I possibly could, myself and the vocalist, the female vocalist named Kayla, a fantastic artist, by the way, an amazing person, came in and recorded this. So this is my part of the vocal. Don't laugh at me. Wow. And then this, of course, Kayla, who sounds a hell of a lot better than I do, this is her part of the vocal. And so all together, when you add that to the production that we made, this is what you get. It's the original. Remake. Original. So what ended up happening is recreated the sample, inserted into the production. Everything was good. Record comes out, ends up being a number one song. The rest is history. Except the interesting thing about this is Annie, after having heard Nicki's version of this song out and after it went number one, still believed that she was hearing herself in the master. Mind you, we replaced her. We took her out. That's my voice. That's Kayla's voice. We totally took her out because we wanted to respect the fact that she didn't want her voice associated with it. That's fine. But after recreating it, she heard the record and she was like, they never took my master out. So I had to prove to them in front of a table of lawyers. I showed them essentially what I just showed you. That's a recreation. So then the record comes out and it becomes a number one record. So I want to say happy 13th anniversary to Nicki Minaj, to Pop Wanzel, who's also on this record, obviously to myself, and to Annie Lennox, because I'm actually a huge fan of her. So the fact that she heard a recreation of one of her songs and thought she was hearing one of her originals actually was really flattering to me as a creative. So shout out to her as well.